Severed body parts, dead women, and grisly clinic conditions. That's Kermit Gosnell's House of Horrors. But it's just business as usual for Planned Parenthood. Next on the American Life League Report. The grisly testimonies of what happened in Kermit Gosnell's abortion factory have shocked people from all walks of life, as details unfolded during his trial. He severed the spinal cords of born-alive infants and joked about his victims as he slaughtered them. The grand jury report explained that there was blood on the floor, a stench of urine filled the air, cat feces on the stairs, semi-conscious women moaning on dirty recliners covered with blood-stained blankets, all sedated by unlicensed staffers. And if that isn't enough to churn your stomach, add to this the fact that the bodies of aborted babies were stuffed into milk jugs, garbage cans, and cat food containers, while body parts stopped up the toilets and jars of tiny severed feet lined the shelves. This is the trial of the century because it exposes the abortion industry's dirty little secret. Abortion is a monstrous act that tears babies apart limb from limb and twists the soul of the abortionist into a heartless sociopath. According to the testimony of Gosnell's former employees, Gosnell jammed scissors into the back of the neck of babies who were born alive and snipped the spinal cord. But don't think for a second that Gosnell is the only one who doesn't care about babies born alive. Planned Parenthood lobbyist Elisa Lapalt-Snow said on record in a public hearing that if a baby is born alive after an abortion takes place, the decision regarding what to do with that baby should be left up to the mother and her abortionist. Lapalt-Snow makes Planned Parenthood's position clear. It has no intention of helping a baby. When a mother wants an abortion, Planned Parenthood, like Gosnell, will provide a dead baby by any means necessary. In February of 2011, when Gosnell was arrested, Planned Parenthood CEO Dale Steinberg said, "Planned Parenthood strongly condemns the alleged actions of Kermit Gosnell, and we would condemn any physician or healthcare provider who did not follow the law or recklessly endangered the health of others. Planned Parenthood maintains strict policies and procedures to ensure the highest standard of healthcare." Really? At the same time jurists in the Gosnell trial were listening to the testimony of Gosnell's staff describe the filth of the Gosnell facility, two former Planned Parenthood of Delaware employees blew the whistle on unsanitary and dangerous conditions at the Planned Parenthood facility that they worked for.
It was just unsafe. I couldn't tell you how ridiculously unsafe it was. He didn't wear gloves, yes. He didn't believe in, he didn't need to wear them.
They were using instruments on patients that were not sterile.
It's not washed down. It's not even cleaned off, you know. It has bloody drainage on it.
They could be at risk of getting hepatitis.
Is this the highest standard of healthcare claimed by Planned Parenthood CEOs? And while Planned Parenthood is busy condemning Gosnell, as it would condemn any physician who recklessly endangered the health of others, perhaps it's also willing to condemn its own facilities that have harmed many, many women. Let's look at just two, like this one in Chicago. See, one of the murder charges Kermit Gosnell is on trial for is the death of a 41-year-old woman who was given an overdose of pain medication by his unlicensed and untrained staff. But Planned Parenthood of Illinois in Chicago killed 24-year-old Tanya Reeves. Reeves' uterus had been perforated by the abortionist, and instead of calling 911, Planned Parenthood let her continue to bleed in their own office for 5 hours before sending her to the hospital where she was pronounced dead. So much for strict policies and procedures. And the one in Colorado. In Colorado, a young woman is suing Planned Parenthood because its abortionist forced her to have an abortion after she changed her mind and left body parts of the baby in her womb, and when she continued to bleed profusely and became septic, Planned Parenthood refused to provide her emergency care. There you have it. Planned Parenthood says it doesn't care about babies born alive at its abortion facilities. Its own employees talk about its unsafe and filthy conditions. Planned Parenthood refuses to care for its own patients. More than one woman has died because she believed Planned Parenthood's lie that it provides the highest standard of health care. yet it still gets millions of taxpayer dollars every year. Planned Parenthood's murder-for-profit business model must be closed permanently, and it starts with the end of taxpayer funding. Check out the Defund Planned Parenthood Action Center at stopplannedparenthood.com. Help us make the nation's largest retail abortion chain close its doors forever. For American Life League, I'm Michael Hitchborn.